Are we turning into animals?
I just think that, you know, maybe monogamy might be a man-made concept.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Fung Bros on the Street. Today, I am asking Asian Americans about dating and hooking up and relationships. Because as you guys know, in this day and age, a lot of people say, oh, I'm tired of dating. It's hard to date. I don't like to date. You know what? I'm just here to find out why. What can we do? And has the hookup culture gone too far? This video is in partnership with East Me East, the number one Asian dating site and live streaming community. So shout out to them. Let's go see what we find out. Why is it so hard to date nowadays? Why do people say that?
I feel like it's just hard to date in LA. It's easier to meet people, but it's harder to commit to one person.
Yeah, like so a friend visited from San Fran and then she was like, wow, like LA has so many things to do here. Like, now I get it why people are not like committed to relationships.
When you meet someone or like after you meet them, it's like you go on like social media and you like try to find them. So it's a bit of like, you have to like background check people already. So you don't kind of like get to know them for like who they are like face to face.
Like I'm in my 20s, I'm kind of like discovering myself and like focusing on me. I'm not trying to like go out and like make some stuff happen, you know?
I think it's all about trust. Like people don't trust like anyone in nowadays.
Why do people just hook up with people? Like, what do they gain from that versus relationships?
Probably fear of commitment. Fear there's something better.
Temporary satisfaction.
Okay.
There's, like, no strings attached and, like, there's no feelings involved. So you can just do whatever you want and no one gets hurt.
Isn't that more like how animals do it?
Monogamy might be a man-made concept.
It allows people to have that comfort to be with somebody, but it doesn't, like, require them to kind of divert from why they're here originally.
Instead of like, oh, I have to like continue this relationship with this person, it's a lot of work, like they don't want to deal with that because that's not their priority in life.
I think most of the people I know though, they kind of like go into the hookup culture after they have like a significant breakup. You know that you're attractive, you know that people want you, and that's why like, you know, you keep like hooking up with people.
What kind of dater are you? Where would you say? Are you more on the old school? You're like, I've dated around and found somebody, or you like where do you fall?
I guess it's like a dating app. With my experience in general, I don't really use it for anything serious, but I just come out with no expectations. So just like whatever happens, happens.
I can tell you work out, bro. did you post some of that on your profile?
He did. It's all just workout stuff.
I like to just sort of like hang out and not have that pressure of like, where is this going from like the get-go?
Because I'm getting older and I feel like, yeah, it's time to like settle down.
You're getting older, how old are you?
23.
I think for me, if it happens, it happens. So I'll meet them naturally, so, and see where it goes.
Okay. Like when I date, I think I have the intent to like make it a long-term thing. It's just too complicated to like keep up with like multiple people.
I can barely keep track of her alone, so.
There are so many ways to meet people nowadays, whether that's through online or events or church or wherever. But still, with that said, Asian Americans are still facing a lot of frustrations when it comes to the time it takes to meet and find a soulmate. So that's why I've partnered with East Meet East, the number one Asian dating site and live streaming community. They've came up with a brand new way to meet your soulmate by bringing the live element back into dating so that people don't have to wait so long. They have a live show called Asian Bachelor Bachelorette. Basically, it's an online version of the TV reality show, and everyone can tune in to win a date with a contestant. So download the app by clicking on the link in the description box below. Let's go see if this would interest people.
Yeah, if there's like an Asian Bachelor type of show online, I would definitely watch it.
That sounds cool. I mean, I'd be surprised to see how it goes.
If the Asian Bachelor and Bachelorette show sound interesting to you, then you guys can tune in twice a week. You guys don't have to participate. You guys can just enjoy it as an audience member. And also, guys, there's all types of other Asian celebrities and Instagrammers that are involved in the show as well, so definitely check it out. And by the way, they are taking nominations for the show right now. So if you want to nominate yourself or nominate a friend, tag their Instagram in the comments down below this video, and maybe they could be on the Asian Bachelor Bachelorette show. All right, let's go talk to more people. What's the future looking like for all of us in our generation? Are we ever gonna find the people we love? Are we just gonna focus on our careers? Are there gonna be any more kids, families?
Lonely, empty.
Not everyone's like that. You know, like, yeah. I feel like people in LA tend to be more like that, but I think globally, that's not like that big of an issue. There's still a lot of people who like would prefer that and who enjoy that. I think it's just a difference.
Dog kids.
Yeah. I think everyone just goes at their own pace. Like, I feel like some people need to have that time to just like hoe out a bit and figure out what they like and what they don't like. And then once they're ready to settle, then they know when they're ready to settle.
It will still continue as to having a family, but maybe the meeting method would be different because people might focus more on using social media apps to meet people.
I mean, I feel like it's more into that little bit of dating app kind of thing. That's going to be really one. You can meet anyone anyway.
What was your bio?
my bio was looking for someone to call my boo on the streets and daddy in the sheets.
I've tried all those apps and stuff, and it's like, I think I really need to meet a person to see whether or not there's something there.
Yeah, my best friend just had a baby, or we found out she was pregnant. So yeah, I totally think there's going to be lots of internet babies being made.
Advice for people who have trouble dating.
Be patient. Just let it happen.
Over the summer, I just realized, you know, I was just talking to too many people. It was just overwhelming, and I didn't have a chance to just, like, focus on myself.
Work on yourself, and when you're at a place where you're aligned with where you need to be, I think that person will find its way.
If you're not meeting a lot of people in one city, then maybe you can consider moving to a different city. People don't have to be stuck in the same place for a really long time. And
you think being buff and kind of showing that off is one of the better ways to at least get your points up?
I think so, just a little bit, you know, because like people say that looks don't matter, but I mean, like, you're swiping left and right. I mean, come on, you gotta have a little bit of something. But
don't have a boring bio, actually say something about yourself.
The three pictures you like definitely need to have. The first picture is you with a bunch of dogs. The right. Second one is you and your boys, right? But you gotta be in the middle. Third picture, I think, is like you with a group of girls. Makes you more valuable.
You miss 100% of the chances you don't take. So I feel like shoot your shot, but do it respectfully, you know.
Thank you everybody for watching that video, and big shout out to East Meet East, the number one Asian dating site and a live streaming community. Remember guys, join the Asian Bachelorette show by clicking on the link in the description box below. Three main takeaways from talking to all these people today. Number one is that maybe the hookup culture is not really the issue, but it's the lack of human connection that's the issue. So often that does come with possibly hooking up, but either way, whether you're dating online or in person or just hooking up, try to find the human connection. That's the main goal. And point number two, generally people said, go and shoot your shot like a gentleman though. Do it in a respectful, non-creepy way, please. And then point number three, is that people are generally optimistic for the future of relationships. They think that these oftentimes are just phases that people go through in their lives. So we shouldn't be too worried about the hookup culture, but just do it mindfully and do it safe. All right, so remember in the comments down below, if you want to nominate yourself or your friend to be on the Asian Bachelor or Bachelorette show on East Meet East, the live version, then leave their Instagram tags down below. And also, I want to hear your guys' feedback. Do you guys think dating is doomed in 2020? Has the hookup culture gone too far? What do you guys think? All right, everybody. Thanks for watching. That's Andrew from the Fung Bros. And until next time, I'm out. Peace.